Hello once again, my Crystaliers, and welcome back to some more Firewatch. Okay, so we'll continue the amazing story of Henry, whatever his last name is, and who... Oh, okay, and let's see if we can find some dumb teenagers. Okay, so let's see here. Let's see, Two Forks Fire Lookout is where I should go. Let's go over here though, because it says something about a, what is that, a loot crate? Well, not a loot crate, but a supply drop. So, let's go over there, and hopefully, I don't know, I don't have to beat someone up. You know what I'm saying? I have to catch these fists. There's nothing, wait, okay. For a second I kind of thought I saw someone. Let's check out the view here. A little bit of weird texture stuff there, but it's fine. Okay. Okay, so... Alright, the sign says something about a box, and I want to pick up that box. Supply drop. Let's see what we got. Hopefully there's not a bunch of Red Eagle beer cans in there. Or my underwear that says, go to hell on it. That'd be nice to not have. Okay. What is this again? Okay, I remember. 1, 2, 3, 4. Should be at least. Okay, cool. Okay, what we got? Nothing. Nothing. And nothing. Okay, awesome. Wait, what? It's just like... Is it just like plant stuff? Why would I care about that? What is that? I don't get that. Well, that was dumb. I thought it was going to be like, you know, like another map thing, maybe another note thing. Who knows, you know, just stuff, but that was like literally nothing. Alright, let's jog our way back to where I'm supposed to go and, you know, see if we can find those teens. I don't know what's going to happen. Delilah told me to scare them, but I don't see why that's a good idea. Because this could end up being just a crazy prank war thing. I don't want to get into a prank war with a bunch of teenagers. Especially since I'm all by myself. And they are more than me, you know what I mean? I am one and they are two and or more people. What's this about?
There's an abandoned pack out here.
And it's not one of the teens?
No, it looks like it was lost a long time ago.
Well, you could always pilfer it for supplies.
Sure, why not? Oh, whoa. Brian Goodwin. Okay, what do you got, Brian? Ow, jeez. Oh, I have a camera now. Ooh, great.
Well, I am flush with ropes now. That awesome. Pack was full of them, in decent condition, too.
That's lucky.
I mean, there's enough rope here that I could just leave them hooked up, I think. Oh, get this. This pack came with one of those cardboard single-use cameras.
Cardboard.
With pictures left?
I get it.
Yeah, he only used 3 or 4.
Neato.
Thank you, Brian Goodwin.
Okay, I can take pictures.
The bag had the name Brian Goodwin sewn into the top.
Huh. Wow.
Do you know him?
I remember these cameras.
I haven't heard that name in a few years.
Wait, she knows who that is?
Was he a ranger or something?
Oh, no. He was stationed in Two Forks, your lookout, with his dad Ned 3 summers ago.
Woo.
Great kid.
You can bring children out here?
No. You know, I'm not a stickler for rules. They took off halfway through the summer.
Okay.
Why? Why? Where did they go?
I don't know. I never really hit it off with old Ned, and one day they were just gone. Sucks. Anyway, so it
were
goes.
Were they dating?
Have fun with that camera. Try not to snap anything that would scar a photo dome employee.
I don't know. I got a lot of hiking to do. Might get bored.
Well, I'm bored as rocks, so I'll keep you company while you find those girls, huh?
Sure. Also, what the heck is that?
I see a really thin plume of smoke.
Yeah, I see it too. A thin plume like this is either a new fire or a campfire.
Oh, jeez.
Campfire? You think it's them?
I reckon so.
It looks like it's to the southwest of me.
Mm-hmm.
That's right. If you hike towards Five Mile Creek, that should put you in the neighborhood.
I mean, I can only hope that it's a campfire.
Any larger.
Will do.
Supply cache. Oh, what? I'm not gonna have. Take note. Take notes. Okay, examine. Alright, let's see here. Dave. Guess who's going out with Debbie next week? No, not that heel Steve. It's your man, Ron. I went up to check on the new guy at Two Forks and heard him talking to himself more than usual for LOs? I don't know. So I figured I'd stay away. Remember, when you saw Chimney Rock having himself in that hammock, I'm starting to think the Forest Service only picks the deranged and perverted. Except for us, of course. We're the creme de la creme. Let's toast to Deb with the spot. Okay. Weird guy. Oh. Oh. This is a lot easier to read. I should maybe do that next time. Oh, I can keep this. Sure, why not? What's this? Tab to review kept notes. A loose stone. Okay, not a big deal. What the heck is this?
Someone found a fossil and put it in a cache box.
Could be the same person who left that antler.
And maybe they're leaving me an entire creature, piece by piece.
Yeah, and a moose raptor or a deer or raptor? What was the antler that we had? It wasn't like a moose antler. It was like a deerish looking type of antler.
Sorry about snapping at you earlier. I thought about it, and yeah, I suppose that must have sounded kind of weird when you heard me take that other call. Plus, you're just out here in your own head. Trust me, I know how it is. So,
I'll just leave that there.
Did you break any hearts back in Colorado when you took this job?
Oh, man,
I
not
myself
that
have chosen
again.
To never get attached to anyone who would miss me, but I know I'm a bit of an outlier. I don't mean that the way it sounds. I mean, I care about people, and I like companionship as much as the next person.
I'm actually married.
But you're here.
Everything's fine. Just, you know, taking some time apart, getting some fresh air.
A little change.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Well, we can just leave it at that.
Thanks.
Man, this is tough stuff, dude. I mean, the whole point of me having this job is to kind of get away a little bit from the whole situation with Julia. Julia's living with her
parents, right? I'm having a hell of a time getting this fucking flapjack off his ass and out to repair that wire.
What are you talking about?
Excuse me? Flapjack?
You know, like a loser. A chotch.
I really don't, but I do now.
Well, the next time you're at a bar and some banker steps on your foot so he can order his crappy martini, you've got just the name to use.
Right. Oh, wait,
Hey, Flapjack, why don't you wait your turn before I bounce your face off a dumpster?
It's beautiful!
I think I should go this way. I find it really hard to pay attention to, sometimes I find it hard to pay attention to what, like, my objectives are and what they say because of other things
hey,
I'm looking at and
Delilah?
Reading.
What do you got? You found
he
him?
Said, hey there, Delilah.
No, not yet. Why would there be a fence out here?
Because sometimes hikers go ass over tea kettle when on a trail.
So the Forest Service would put up a big chain-link fence?
A chain-link fence?
Yeah. It looks like it surrounds a huge area.
Huh. That's weird.
What? You didn't know about that?
Who are they keeping out of here? And why?
Jeez, I don't know. Maybe it's biologists, you know? Well, they don't want people traipsing on their precious lichens.
Lichens?
What's a lichen?
Wouldn't you liken to know?
Oh my god, goodbye.
Uh-huh.
I'll ask next time I talk to someone, but that'll probably be a few days.
Oh, she doesn't know what a lichen is? The second she said lichen, I was thinking about werewolves. That's a different word for werewolf, right? I ain't crazy, right? I'm not a crazy guy. That's really weird that she... Not only is there a fence. I mean, the fence isn't inherently that strange. Whoa. My game just froze up for a second. Not only is there a fence, because, like I said, the fence inherently isn't weird by itself, but, like, she didn't know about it, and she thought it was weird herself, and she's the one that, you know, works here all the time, and she's the boss, and she would know, right? Is that it? Oh, it's music. Okay. Let's listen to this one. I'm over here. I'm actually not sure where I should be going. Cut palm wire. Walking around over here. I'm gonna assume this might be the right way over here. When that song first started, I thought it was a weird sound of like a. Let's go! Yeah! Of a plane.
Just so you know, I didn't mean to overstep my bounds earlier when you brought up your wife.
That's fine.
I know you didn't. You were just making conversation. I appreciate it.
So, tell me about her, if you want.
She's a college professor. She's a PhD in biology, evolution, and stuff.
Evolution. That's a risque subject in these parts. Man, she sounds sexy.
She sure was.
Where does she teach?
Boulder.
That's a great school. My cousin went
there.
She
sure was.
Yeah. Anyway, that's her.
I think the next opportunity. Oh, hello.
Wow. I'm on top of a natural bridge out here.
Really? Is it a complete arch?
No, I guess the bridge is out here. Still, I think I could jump this gap to get across the canyon.
Wow, well, you're a regular Evel Knievel.
Oh yeah, you should see the jumpsuit I'm wearing.
I did it. Take a picture. Okay, so I think I'm still going the right way. Let's do a hop. Oh, okay. We don't need a 127 hours to happen out here by myself. I want both of my arms today, please, sir. So, I think the next opportunity I have to tell her about how my wife is sick is when I will tell her about that my wife is sick. Because she's been pretty nice enough and, you know, we're getting to know each other a little bit more. So, yeah. I think that'll be fine. So yeah, the next little like conversational choice where I have the opportunity to say that she's like not good, she's not in a good condition at the moment, or blah blah blah, then I'll do that, see what happens. You know, hopefully that wasn't like the last time I could have done that or anything. Okay, so let's see, the smoke is on my right, pretty sure. I was seeing if maybe me looking in its direction would tell me if it's there or not. Oh, there it is. It only happens if I'm actually physically staring at it. Oh, it's not obstructed. There's some pretty wild. This, like, seems like an actual wild brush area. There's no. Doesn't seem like actual paths and things. Can I crouch? Is there a crouch button? Guess not. Okay, well, I press control. That's usually the crouch button. Two Forks Tower on the left. Jonesy Lake on the right. Well, I need to go to the right, so let's go. Jonesy Lake. That's not the lake where they were skinny dipping, was it? Oh, I didn't have to unlock that. Okay. Okay, maybe someone already unlocked that. Right, well, nothing there. Beautiful yellow color. It pops out of the environment really well, so you can, you know, it catches your eye and you get to open it up. I'm assuming I'm going the right way over here. So let's pop a squat. Well, you know, pop a squat means squat. Or like kneeling or something.
But man, I wanted to say was you had a full-on PhD at home. Part of me thinks that would be insufferable, But then there's another part of me that can't help but indulge the whole hot for teacher thing. You know, heavy petting in the book stacks. Furtive glances during lecture. Oh, office hours roleplay. But professor, I can't fail chemistry. Isn't there anything I can do to pass the class?
Okay, cool it down.
Oof, not sure we can stop this train now.
You are ridiculous.
Come on, I'm just teasing.
I think I know
that academia is a pain in the ass. Professors go wherever they can get tenure.
I should have said the sick thing since I just said I would do that. Dang it. I lied to you by accident, fellow viewers. I'm sorry. I just expected more conversation, so I'm like, the next time, it's steep, she has said. Should I take a picture of this? This is a nice picture, actually. Let me do this. That was nice. Also, maybe could be considered evidence if something weird happens where they're like, no, I didn't have no fire, whatever.
Nope.
It still seems thin, so it's not spreading, so at least it's not actual wildfire. Most likely it's a campfire of jerky teens situation. So, I wanted to point out that bit of dialogue when he first got the ropes. He's like, oh man, there's so much ropes that I could just leave these lying around. It's funny. I like that. Because it's like, in a video game kind of thing, it's like, not mentioned. It's like, if the character has the ability to, you know, rappel and go up, up and down different types of ropes. Should I go down here? Where am I? Okay, I'm over here. Jonesy Lake. Campfire smoke is this way. So yeah, I think I should rappel down here. Okay, let's hook that up. Thank you, Mr. What was his name? Brian, I think his name was. Brian Goodwin, I think it was. Not super sure, but I think it was. Alright. Thank you, Mr. Sir. What happened to that person? Did she mention what happened to them? Because it sounded like something bad happened. It seems like it, because his cat was just lying around.
What happened with the professor? If you guys had so much fun, when did it stop?
When she got sick, that's when it stopped.
Oh, my God,
Yeah, it's okay.
I mean, fuck, what happened?
We can talk about it later.
Okay. Okay, Henry. What's her name?
Julia.
Can't blame you don't know anything, so.
That's a nice name.
Thank you. Not that it, you know, has anything to do with me, but thank you. I mean, you know, I'm just like, when I play video games by myself, right? And it's the, kind of the whole point of the game is to kind of associate yourself with the person or character, the main character that you're playing with. So I'm very much doing that. So I'll be sometimes more or less role-playing. So I'll say stuff like that just to, I guess, quote-unquote, explain myself. And yeah, let's do that. 1, 2, 3. Oh, wait, there we go. So yeah, I'm feeling missing person. That guy looks like me.
How many hikers go missing in the Shoshone?
More than none, unfortunately, with most of them being in this
Mitch
area.
Michaels.
The thoroughfare, because it's so remote. Why?
I found an old flyer for a missing hiker. It just got me thinking, that's all. Like how you said one day you were talking to the Goodwins, and then the next you weren't.
Ned Goodwin didn't get mauled by a bear or stuck in a ravine. He was just a PTSD'd a-hole who dragged his son out to do a job and realized it was a bad idea.
Okay, so I'm gonna keep that, by the way.
PTSD? That doesn't sound good.
Yeah, I don't know. He was in the army. He was off. It's actually the saddest story. He was only discharged because his mother, Brian's grandmother, died. She'd been taking care of him, and Ned was the only next of kin.
Damn. And you got to know Brian a little bit?
Yeah. I talked to him way more than I'd talked to Ned, that's for sure.
How was he at, spotting fires?
Better than you. He actually liked to stay in the tower.
Boy, for as dry as it is this summer, there's an area down here that's lush.
I love these types
of trees.
Oh, you
must be talking about the Aspen Grove down there.
Like yeah, they have I think eyes that's on
them.
Where I am.
No, it's sort of creepy.
Those trees are actually awesome. One root organism. Did you know that?
I kind of didn't, actually.
I didn't.
Yeah, they share their water as a colony that can live for hundreds of years, even through fire. Can you believe you're actually getting paid to learn all of these amazing things?
Whoa.
Also, by what it looks like on this map, you'll be coming up on a stream that should lead you towards where we saw that smoke.
Beautiful. That was awesome. Okay. Is that a drum? There's like not a lot of music that comes from the actual game, so whenever I hear any kind of actual music, I'm like, is that music or is that a sound effect that's just happening? But I'm actually out of time for this episode. Sorry guys, I'm gonna have to do another cliffhanger. So thank you so much for watching. My name is Crystal Face, and we'll pick this up on the next episode. This is an awesome, you know, music that just happened. What great timing! And I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.